Hello. In today's lecture, we'll be talking about spiral of Tillaux. This is a subtopic under extraocular muscle. It's very important for every optometrist to get this idea or this concept, as it tells you that the insertion of the rectus muscle are not at the same point from the corneal scleral junction. However, this will give you a broad and a general idea about how the rectus muscles are inserted. We're talking about spiral of Tillaux. Okay, spiral of Tillaux is an imaginary line which joins the various insertions of the rectus muscle. If you should take the rectus muscle, they are originated from the common terminus ring, and this ring is a ring of fibrous connective tissue. Okay, so we have the common terminus ring. Let's say it's somewhere here. Okay, this ring has several names. We can call it common terminus ring, or annulus of Zinc, or better still, annular tendon. So they are all talking about one particular thing. Now, the extraocular muscles are originated from this part of the common terminus ring, and they are inserting to the anterior aspect of the equator. Okay, so if you should take the eye, the equator divides the globe into posterior and anterior. The rectus muscles originate from the common terminus ring, and they get inserted at the anterior aspect of the equator. Okay, so this is the common terminus ring. Let's say this is the eye. This is the eyeball. Okay. Alright, so this is the eyeball, and let's say the common terminus ring is somewhere here. Okay, now the equator is dividing the globe into posterior and interior. Posterior. Okay, so you have this is the equator, and it's dividing the globe into posterior and interior. So this is the posterior part of the globe, and this is the anterior part of the globe. Alright, so the common terminus ring, they have the rectus muscle, and they are originated from this part. So you have the superior rectus over here, you have the inferior rectus over here, we are having the lateral rectus over here, and you are having the medial rectus over here. All these rectus muscles are inserted to the anterior aspect of the equator. Alright, so they will all come from here, and they will get inserted at this part. This will come and continue to the anterior aspect of the equator. The same thing happens to the medial rectus, also inserting here, and then the inferior rectus also down here. So you are having the inferior rectus here, and you are having the medial rectus over here. The same thing applies to the lateral rectus, and then the superior rectus. So all these are rectus muscles, and then inserting at the anterior aspect of the equator. Now, before you can know the spiral of Tillaux, we know it's a major line which joins the various insertions of the rectus muscle to form something like a spiral. Okay, good. So now this, we look at the side view of the eyeball. Now look at the anterior view of the eyeball, and we know how these rectus muscles are being inserted and how they are able to form something like a spiral. And the major line is joined to join them. Okay. All right. So that was my time. All right. So this is the eyeball, and you have the corneal scleral or the lumbus over here. Okay. Listen. This is the lumbus. Or the corneal scleral junction. This is the lumbus or corneal scleral junction at this part. Okay, corneal scleral junction. So you can cornea and the scleral, where they meet is referred to as lumbus, or the cornea and scleral junction. You see, corneal scleral junction. All right. So let's say we have the nose. Let's say we have the nose here. We have the nose here. Okay. All right. So this is towards the nose. So this is the medial side. Okay. Good. And this is the lateral side. All right. So we have the insertions. We know that the rectus muscle inserts at the anterior aspect of the globe or the equator. All right. So the distance between the corneal scleral junction and then the medial rectus is 5.5 millimeters. So from here, the medial rectus muscle will be somewhere here. Okay. This is the muscle, and the distance between them is 5.5 millimeters. That is for the medial rectus. Okay. And when you come to the inferior rectus, is 6.5 millimeters. So they are inserting somewhere here. Okay, so we have the inferior rectus over here and the muscle. So we have inferior rectus. And we have the lateral rectus. Okay, they are inserting at from the insertion and the corneal scleral junction is 6.9 millimeters. Okay, we have 6.9 millimeters. So this is where the muscles, the lateral rectus muscles is inserting. So this is the lateral rectus muscle. And the superior rectus is inserted at the point from the corneal scleral junction is 7.7 millimeters. 7.7 millimeters. Okay, so 7.7 millimeters. So they are inserted now somewhere like this, some point, okay? Good. So you realize that as you are moving from the medial rectus clockwise to the superior rectus, you realize that the distance between the insertion of the muscle and the corneal scleral junction increases. As a result of this, when the medial line is drawn to join them, it will form something like a spiral. Are you okay? Good. So now, this is 5.5 millimeters. So when a medial line is drawn to touch these insertions, since the distance between them as most probability increases, it will form something like a spiral. Okay, so it goes like this. When the medial line is drawn to join these insertions, it will form something like a spiral. Let me use the red marker. Alright, so this is the insertion. So this concept was derived by Tillaux. So as you see, that as the distance between the insertions of the various muscles and then the corneal scleral junction increases, and the medial line is drawn to join them, it forms something like a spiral. So this is the whole concept about spiral of Tillaux. Very simple and easy as that. The general idea over here is that there is the insertion of muscles, the insertion points and the corneal scleral junction are not the same for the rectus muscle. Therefore, when the medial line is drawn to join them, it will form something like a spiral. However, in recent studies, it shows that the distance between the various insertions of the muscle and the corneal scleral junction might be different. But however, the spiral of Tillaux, that spiral arrangement of the insertions of the muscle, must still be observed. Thank you.